This is Scott. This is a book we did.
And it's a good book. And it's a fantastic book to give you a way to prayer and build your prayer practices that work for you. It's changed a lot of lives. And that's not an assumption. We've gotten the emails and all those things. Like, we know that it has worked. And so we have been working on a second one, which we're excited to talk to you about, which is this. May it be so. This is the test version. We're going to be a hardback like this. But may it be so. 40 days in the Lord's Prayer. Why would we go with the Lord's Prayer, Justin?
Well, we're going to pick it up where we left off with this one. This being the first one, part of what we wanted to do with this was to suggest that this angle of prayer, to like, let it be with me as you say, to make the assumption that God is already active, alive, and present to you, and that really what counts is not the particular shape of your prayer, your particular words, but that there is an ongoing, ever-present conversation between you and the divine. We wanted to actually dig in the way that Jesus did when he was asked by people who had been around religion their whole lives, came to him and did that weird kind of confession that I think at some point as an adult, maybe we do over and over. We sort of stop and be like, I actually don't really know what I'm doing.
Don't know how to pray.
I don't really know how to pray.
Right before Jesus gives the Lord's Prayer, he says, your Father in heaven knows everything you need before you ask him. So then say this. And that caveat, like, it's already known.
Yeah.
You're already known. So when you pray, say this. It's an invitation into a reality that's already known.
Yeah.
It's not a list of things to accomplish. That's not what we're being invited into. We're being invited into a way of like being with these truths, these invitations, this mystery unfolding. And that's what this book is getting into.
So just like the last time, there will be a single image and a single prayer for a particular day. It'll look like that. And then there will be reflections on the Lord's Prayer, kind of longer reflections, but these reflections won't be teachings on here's what this verse means. They're going to be kind of these excavations of my own psychology and the way these words dig things out of me as a way to invite you to do the same. How does this reach inside you, get a hold of what's going on in there, and draw things out? You are the content. This is the tool.